Everybody, it's that time of the week where we bring you a glimpse and a perspective of what happened in elections. And depending on how you looked at it, the recent presidential debate that just happened was either Friday Night Fights or Saturday Night Live. Again, depending on what perspective you take. But fortunately, we have the very expert opinions of Sean Gumatautau and Dr. Ron McNinch. Gentlemen, thanks for joining me.
Yep.
Okay, so Sean, you were someone who was involved in debates, covering it for the media. And again, you prepared Governor Calvo when you were part of his administration. What did you think of the tone, the aggressiveness, the back and forth between Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump this past week?
You can tell that there was a lot of preparation done by Secretary Clinton for this particular event. It seemed like she might have had so much information that she waited for an opportunity to throw some daggers at Donald Trump. And in fact, quite a number of them stuck, and he really just couldn't pull himself out of it. I think the first 25 minutes was a really good debate for Donald Trump, but in a 90-minute debate, the other 70 was all Hillary Clinton.
Now, Ron, because this is, you know, the first of three debates, do you think that Trump was maybe, you know, like pulling some punches, or maybe being strategically, you know, holding off and saying, you know, I'm not going to go out, you know, guns blazing in the first one. Let me kind of like feel my way out, and in part two and part three, I now have material to work with? Or did he just, you know, get caught?
I think that Hillary and Trump are night and day. I think that he's a media star. I think that when people see Trump, they feel like they know him. They've had mental conversations with Trump. Hillary, she's first lady. They don't have those kinds of thinking interactions with Hillary they do with Trump. So he has a home court advantage. And you know, he is the Republican nominee because he rolled up and rolled over every Republican candidate in a debate format. Mm-hmm. And
very
so
true.
We still are waiting on the other two. I watched it very actively, and I know Sean mentioned he watched it twice, and it's certainly well worth watching.
And good of you to notice that, you know, and point out the fact that Hillary is the former first lady, because the debate format in its purest sense is supposed to be a structured, you know, between gentlemen and ladies, you know, a dissemination of issues and everything like that. But this one was further from that. There was even, you know, slings and arrows being tossed back and forth afterwards. We're saying, I had some inside stuff that I could have gone with, but I held back and everything. So, you know, what do you think about the mudslinging?
Actually, the mudslinging, I think the American people could have done without. But also, the amount of fact-checking on the fly, I really didn't think that all of it was that accurate. And I waited till after to kind of start looking at myself. I think most Americans, if they watched, they probably could have done that. But it was the on-the-fly fact-checking just made it, just kind of drug out the 90 minutes.
Mm-hmm. Now, Ron, when you instruct young minds and, you know, the leaders of tomorrow in the debate format and everything, given this past debate that happened between Hillary and the Donald, what do you tell them to take away from that, pro and con?
I mean, here's the neat thing about it, is debates in a political context are not about logic, it's not about facts, it's about emotion. It's how people feel. People will never forget how they feel, and that's Maya Angelou said, people will never forget how you make them feel. And so really, in the modern media age with political candidates, it's how our candidates make them feel, regardless of what they say and the big plans they have and all the other stuff.
Now let's kind of dovetail this to the local perspective, because in all your years, each of you gentlemen, covering, being involved with debates, who should Guamanians look to as like, that person, man or woman, was an expert in the art of debate? I know the late Angel Santos was very, very adept when he debated.
You know, I will say, in working in the speeches and in debates, there are a couple of folks out there who are absolutely some of the best minds to craft message. Right now, to me, is Simon Sanchez. He comes out. He's not going to debate you, but he is great at putting together the arguments and putting together the right type of feeling for debates, to me.
Okay, Ron, last word is yours.
I think it's just getting that feeling to the people, where people feel they know you, and if they feel they know you, they're gonna vote for you. And I think that's why Trump has the edge, is people actually think they know him.
Okay, so at least insofar as our unofficial scorecards are Trump 1, or Trump 0, Hillary 1 at this point.
I think it was a toss-up, but we got two more to go.
Yeah. Okay.
That's right.
That's a good word from two big sports fans as well. So, hey, and it is captive TV. Everybody's watching it online. Everybody's watching it on TV.
Right.
So we'll see you at debate number two, and that's coming up. Stay tuned. We are back after this.